you stay, at least until the sun goes down. When you're gone.
Morning, we're gonna go for a little surf. We just checked the waves, they're looking so glassy and nice, so I'm really excited. And I'm in such, I always get so like excited that I just want to get into the water, so I'm stressed. I need to go.
Your bikini is nice.
Thank you. It's from Billabong. I got it the day on, like, when I went to the airport. I got it at the mall before. It's so nice. I'm excited to go surfing in a bikini.
Yeah, warm water is the best.
Let's go.
Sometimes I think about myself. I wish I was somewhere else. Far from my fear, anxiety, far from my weakness. I could be gone, gone, but I'm just afraid. I refuse to fix the problem, and I think I can carry on. You can lie, you can try, but you'd like to leave this feeling. We got to breathe, to dig, to leave the life we are dreaming. It could go wrong, wrong, but I'm just a nest. You must be lonely, but you could be crazy if you keep looking down. Don't you cry no more.
Even if I hate my
no more.
Even if I want the more you're here.
Just got out of the water from the surf. We took turns because we were filming, but it was so busy.
There were so many people. Everyone here is so good.
I've never been anywhere, like, ever, where there was so many good people in one place. Like, in Portugal, there's a lot of people in the lineup, but, like, not everyone takes a wave, not everyone catches a wave. Here, everyone, like is in the water, rips. Like, they're so good. I feel like such a kook here in the water. But it was still fun. Like, I got one nice one and then two that were not so nice. But it's not about the quantity, it's about the quality, and the quality was actually not that great either.
I think, yeah.
Janine got such a nice one. Yeah, you will have seen it because she was like going to the nose. She was like,
it was very smooth.
And it was so funny. The other day we were here, we were renting the boards, and this guy who was renting them to us was like, yeah, do you girls nose ride? And we're like, no, not yet. And he was like, it's not that hard. We're like, kind of is. But yeah, we're just getting breakfast now. We're getting some pancakes. I went for the chocolate and Nutella or whatever pancake, and Janine got the healthier version with like
fruits.
They're vegan. Oh, they're
vegan.
Very nice. Very good. Let's try this. Mmm. So delicious.
Yeah?
This one is a puppy and he's got very sharp teeth. You have very sharp teeth. You are a baby.
Janine is scared of the puppy. She can't sit.
Puppy, come. Spicy.
Come
bite her. She doesn't want to sit.
It's so funny.
Just got back from the surf and it was so fun. I think I already gave you a brief update, but the waves. Oh, it was just so nice to go surfing in warm water. Like, it doesn't even matter if I didn't get that many waves. And always after I go surfing, my skin is so ridiculously dry. Also, my hair looks crazy. But yeah, my skin is always so dry after I go surfing. I think it's just being in the water or general, like in the sun, it just dries out your face. But also, I don't know, tell me if you guys struggle with the same thing. My face doesn't tan as well as my body. Like, is this a general phenomenon or is this just me? Like, it just doesn't, my body gets like really dark. Like, you can see my arms are a lot darker than my face, and just my face doesn't keep up. It didn't get the memo to get tan. So I have found a really good product. My face is all clean, but you know, just after you wash it and it's so dry that it feels like it's gonna tear. That's what it feels like right now. It feels so dry. So let me show you what I use to moisturize in order to match my body with my face, because like I said, my face is always a lot lighter, and also you want to nourish your skin on top of getting a tan. I use the Bali Body Gradual Face Tan Hydrating Cream. First of all, the packaging is so cute. It comes with this little lid which you take off, and then you press down and then the cream comes out. I use about one pump and I just apply that all over my face, and really important, blend it down to your neck because it does have self-tan in it, and just apply that all over your face. Oh my god, it feels so good. I can't even tell you. Can you, like, I feel like I can already see a difference. I mean, can you? I can see myself looking a lot more glowy and like flushed, you know? This gradually builds over 46 hours and it will leave your skin looking like you've just been kissed by the sun. I think it's absolutely genius that they came up with a self-tan and a moisturizer combined in one. And this is honestly such a good moisturizer. Like I said, when I just applied it, it feels so soft on the skin. It feels really nice and hydrating. It's actually also anti-aging, which is great. We love that in a moisturizer. I use this every day, usually in the morning, after I wash my face and before I apply anything else on my face. This is also really nice under makeup. It just leaves you looking really sun-kissed. Tanning your face can be really difficult because you wash it every single day, so the tan just rubs off really quickly. So this is a really good way to maintain the tan on your face. It's 100% natural and vegan, and it's made in Australia. This is a new product from them, and I must say I'm really, really obsessed with this. I'm going to leave all the links in the description down below so you can check them out. And if you're interested, make sure to have a look. We left Kamarata to drive a bit more east today, so more towards the northeast of the island, to check out some beaches there. Janine's already been there last week and she said they're absolutely stunning. And I mean, even just right now, like, drive there, it's so nice to see all the like villages and everything that's like going on. It's super interesting, and I'm excited to see the beaches. Apparently the palm trees are stunning there, right Janine?
Yeah, it's super nice.
Yeah, the traffic is a bit crazy, but in general, like, we always try to rent a car wherever we go or some sort of mode of transport, because I just think it makes you so much more flexible and you can just like pick up and go. You don't necessarily need a car when you're in Kamarata. I think you can walk most places or grab a taxi, but it's definitely nice to have a car if you're planning on doing date trips. And
also for surfing.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a horse. Oh, there's a horse on the side of the road.
So yeah, I mean, that's the best mode of transport for sure, and it's not too expensive, so it was actually perfect. We are on our way to a place called Las Terenas. It's on the east coast and it's about 3 hours from Kamarata. Apparently it's got some of the most beautiful beaches. Everyone says it's super quiet there, a lot calmer than in Kamarata, and it's just extremely beautiful. It's very much the Caribbean dream apparently. So I'm super excited that we're going to go there for 2 nights. We were considering of only going for 1 night, but I think 2 nights is better because then we can just see more. Now we stopped halfway. It's about 1.5 hours from Kamarata and 1.5 hours more to go to where we want to be, at this beautiful road. It's just like, I don't even know how to describe it. It's literally just palm trees everywhere. It's like palm tree heaven. If you like palm trees, you have to go here. Here we have Janine. She's flying the drone. She's very concentrated. She takes her job very serious.
It's tricky because we have so many palm trees. We have this electrical line running.
And everything looks the same because there's palm trees everywhere.
So it's tricky to know.
But she's a good pilot. I've got my faith in her. Las Terenas, and we just checked into our hotel. We're staying at the Mosquito Boutique Hotel, and I'm gonna give you a quick room tour because the location is insane and I really want to show you guys. Okay, so here we have the bathroom. It's really nice, like light and everything. But the highlight of the room for sure is, well, this is the room itself. The highlight of the room is for sure.
Look, Julia, you can sleep in this bed, and this one is for me.
Look at this view. Oh my god, it's like so crazy. I can't believe it. This is the view from our balcony, and we're right on the beach. And it literally, it looks like, it looks better than Maldives, I'd say, so far. It's so insane. So I think the plan now is to chillax for a bit and maybe get a snack at the restaurant.
Yeah, I really want to. I want to.
Oh, we didn't have lunch. I just realized we didn't have lunch. We need to go get lunch.
We should go to the restaurant, eat something, then like just
fly by the beach. Yeah. Let's go.
And then
I hope you can hear me because it is a little bit windy. But we just got to the pool and we ordered some lunch. I got a poke bowl and Jenny got a salad. The only problem is, I said without mango and she thought she was doing a good thing by giving me pineapple instead, but I don't like pineapple either. It's not so bad. I'll show you our food. So this is the poke bowl that I got. It looks so yummy. It's shrimps. Shrimpies. Don't touch them. And then Janine got a yummy salad. And this is our view. I like the view. You do? Ah, you my best view.
I like the view.
You do?
Yes.
You're my best view.
Good morning. Let's check the view. Oh, it doesn't come across on camera. No, it's like pink. It looks like sunset, but it's the morning.
Good morning. I look a little bit like death. Just getting ready this morning because Janine and I want to take some beautiful photos at this insane location. So nice yesterday that we got up early this morning. I mean, I get up early anyway. I woke up 10 minutes before the alarm and I was set at 6 a.m. And we're gonna take some photos. Oh, and I'm curling my hair with this thing. It's the GHD Unplugged. It's the best invention ever because for some reason, here and also in Costa Rica, our curling iron didn't work. So I brought this thing with me and it's perfect. Yeah, so we're just gonna get ready this morning and take some photos. I'm not gonna take you with me because it's just so hectic anyway. Just got ready. My hair is a bit super curly, but it's gonna fall out anyway. Well, hopefully not fall out. I mean, like, it's gonna drop. We're gonna go shoot now. It's looking so beautiful. I'm so excited to take photos, and I will insert photos here now so you can see what kind of pictures we took.
It's sunset time. Well, kind of. It's quite overcast tonight, but I think usually it would be a beautiful sunset here. We've come down to a beach that's 15 minutes from the Mosquito Boutique Hotel where we were staying. It's called Playa Cosan, and a few people have recommended it to me. It's super beautiful, and Janina's itching herself and she's dying to make me stop talking because we've already recorded it three times because my camera died. And also there's so many like sand flies here. It's so bad. It hurts.
They're so horrible. It's like worse than mosquitoes.
It's like little stings and it really hurts. So I think we need to stop this, but we're here for sunset. I don't know if we're going to stay because of the mosquitoes.
And it's not really, it's a bit clouded. But maybe we can check out the palm trees over there. They look nice.
We're just going to walk by the water. Maybe it will get better.
You can just jump down. It's not very high. What the fuck are you doing? Just jump. It's like really not high. Just jump. Please, won't you wait? Won't you stay? At least until the sun goes down. When you're gone, I lose faith. I lose everything I have found. Heartstrings, violence. That's what I hear when you're by my side. Yeah, that's what I hear when you're by my side.
Back in Cabarete now from Las Serenas. It was super beautiful.
I love Las Serenas. I would highly recommend everyone, if you're in the area, to check out Las Serenas. It's so beautiful. It's totally worth the drive, and it's only 3 hours. But we arrived really late last night back in Cabarete, so I didn't vlog anything, but we checked into our new Airbnb, and now we've just come to the surf beach. And the waves are a little bit bigger today, which is why I'm not going out. I don't know, I think I would trust myself to go, but I just don't really want to test myself on the last couple days here. So I'm just gonna have a chilled one and stay at the beach. But Janine's gonna go out and I'm gonna take photos of her.
I've got the camera set up and Janine is gonna go in now and catch some barrels, I hope. I expect nothing less.
Already our last day here. For some reason time has just flown by, and I've already been here for like 10 days, I think. I don't even know, I kind of stopped counting. So today we did a bit of souvenir shopping, which is something I realized I haven't done in so long. Like, I don't know, I don't really like, I usually bring home presents for like my mom or something, but I'll bring her like stuff that she needs. Well, I'm not actually gonna show you what I got her, but I'm gonna show you what I got myself. I got myself some presents. I got myself this bracelet from this street selling person. There's a lot of them here at the beach, and I don't know, I just kind of felt like buying something. I don't know, because I didn't buy myself anything here because there's not really that good shopping. So I got myself this bracelet, which I don't think I'll ever wear because it's quite heavy. But I got myself this necklace. This stone is called Larimar. Wait, I'm gonna Google it. It's called Larimar, and it's this blue rock that's just like really famous here in the Dominican Republic. It's actually quite expensive. The bigger ones were like $30 or something, and bigger as in like this big. So I got this one, and apparently it like cleanses your aura and makes you like, I don't know, healthy. I don't know, but I really like this kind of stuff. So I really like crystals and everything, so I went and got this one, and I really like it. I think it looks so cute. But yeah, it's our last night, so we're gonna go out for sunset drinks, even though it's quite gloomy, and then go out for dinner with some friends here. And this is the end of the vlog. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoyed what I showed you from the Dominican Republic. Let me know in the comments below what you want to see next. I hope I can post some more travel vlogs again, or just normal weekend lives. I love to hear your thoughts, and make sure to like and subscribe to my channel, and thank you all so much for watching. Bye.